Legends have developed around the salamander over the centuries, many related to fire. This connection likely originates from the tendency of many salamanders to dwell inside logs. When the log was placed into a fire, the salamander would attempt to escape, lending credence to the belief that salamanders were created from flames. In the United States, there are 186 different species of salamanders. Salamanders are a group of animals that can survive in water, during their larval stage, and on land, during their adult stage. Typically characterized by their lizard-like appearance, with slender bodies, blunt snouts, short limbs projecting at right angles to the body, and the presence of a tail in both larvae and adults. Blue-spotted salamanders are between 3.9 and 5.5 inches in length, of which the tail comprises 40%. Their skin is bluish-black, with characteristic blue and white flecks on its back, and bluish-white spots on the sides of its body and tail. They have elongated bodies. The vent is typically black, which contrasts with the paler belly. On the other hand, the yellow-spotted salamander is 5.9 to 9.8 inches in length. The yellow-spotted salamander's main color is black, but can sometimes be a bluish-black, dark gray, dark green, or even dark brown. Two uneven rows of yellowish-orange spots run from the top of the head, near the eyes, to the tip of the tail. The spotted salamander's spots near the top of its head are more orange, while the spots on the rest of its body are more yellow. The underside of the yellow-spotted salamander is slate gray and pink. Let's dive into the main topic, salamander. They rarely have more than 4 toes on their front legs and 5 on their rear legs, but some species have fewer digits and others lack hind limbs. Their permeable skin usually makes them reliant on habitats in or near water or other cool, damp places. Some salamander species are fully aquatic throughout their lives, some take to the water intermittently, and others are entirely terrestrial. The skin lacks scales and is moist and smooth to the touch. The skin may be drab or brightly colored, exhibiting various patterns of stripes, bars, spots, blotches, or dots. Males become dramatically colored during the breeding season. Cave species dwelling in darkness lack pigmentation and have a translucent pink or pearlescent appearance. Trunk, limbs, and tail. An adult salamander generally resembles a small lizard, having a 4-limb body form with a cylindrical trunk, 4 limbs, and a long tail. The head, body, and tail have a number of vertical depressions in the surface, which run from the mid-dorsal region to the ventral area and are known as costal grooves. Their function seems to be to help keep the skin moist by channeling water over the surface of the body. Some aquatic species, such as sirens, have reduced or absent hind limbs, giving them an eel-like appearance, but in most species, the front and rear limbs are about the same length and project sideways. Salamanders do not have claws, and the shape of the foot varies according to the animal's habitat. Climbing species have elongated, square-tipped toes, while rock dwellers have larger feet with short, blunt toes. The tree-climbing salamander has plate-like webbed feet which adhere to smooth surfaces by suction, while the rock-climbing web-toed salamander species from California have feet with fleshy webs and short digits, and use their tails as an extra limb. When ascending, the tail props up the rear of the body, while one hind foot moves forward, and then swings to the other side to provide support as the other hind foot advances. In larvae and aquatic salamanders, the tail is laterally flattened and has dorsal and ventral fins. Undulates from side to side to propel the animal through the water. In terrestrial species, the tail moves to counterbalance the animal as it runs. While in the arboreal salamander and other tree-climbing species, it is prehensile. The tail is also used by certain salamanders that can jump to help launch themselves into the air. The tail is used in courtship and as a storage organ for proteins and lipids. It also functions as a defense against predation, when it may be lashed at the attacker or self-amputate when grabbed. Unlike frogs, an adult salamander is able to regenerate limbs and its tail when these are lost. Skin. The skin of salamanders is thin and permeable to water, serves as a respiratory membrane, and is well supplied with glands. It renews periodically through a skin shedding process controlled by hormones from the pituitary and thyroid glands. During molting, the skin initially breaks around the mouth, and the animal moves forwards through the gap to shed the skin. When the front limbs have been worked clear, a series of body ripples pushes the skin towards the rear. The animal often then eats the resulting sloughed skin. Glands in the skin discharge mucus, which keeps the skin moist, an important factor in skin respiration and thermoregulation. The sticky layer helps protect against bacterial infections, reduces friction when swimming, and makes the animal slippery and more difficult for predators to catch. Granular glands, scattered on the upper surface, particularly the head, back, and tail, produce repellent or toxic secretions. Some salamander toxins are particularly potent. The rough-skinned, small, slender-bodied salamander produces the most toxic non-protein substance known. Handling it does no harm, but ingestion of even a minute fragment of skin is deadly. Senses. The sense of smell in salamanders plays a role in territory maintenance, the recognition of predators, and courtship rituals, but is probably secondary to sight during prey selection and feeding. They have two types of sensory areas that respond to the chemistry of the environment. The eyes are adapted primarily for vision at night. In some permanently aquatic species, they are reduced in size and have a simplified retinal structure. And in cave dwellers, such as the Georgia blind salamander, they are absent or covered with a layer of skin to find their prey. They use trichromatic color vision extending into the ultraviolet range. All salamanders lack eardrum, but they have an operculous system like frogs and are still able to detect airborne sound. Salamanders are usually considered to have no voice and do not use sound for communication in the way that frogs do. However, during mating, they communicate by pheromone signaling. Some species can make quiet ticking or popping noises, perhaps by the opening and closing of valves in the nose. Feeding and diet. Salamanders are opportunistic predators. They are generally not restricted to specific foods, but feed on almost any organism of a reasonable size. Some eat crabs, fish, and aquatic insects. Smaller dusky salamanders' diet includes earthworms, flies, beetles, beetle larvae, leafhoppers, springtails, moths, spiders, grasshoppers, and mites. Cannibalism sometimes takes place, especially when resources are short or time is limited. Tiger salamander tadpoles in ephemeral pools sometimes resort to eating each other and are seemingly able to target unrelated individuals. Adult black-belly salamanders prey on adults and young of other species of salamanders, while their larvae sometimes cannibalize smaller larvae. Yellow-spotted salamanders feed on earthworms, slugs, snails, spiders, millipedes, centipedes, insects, and other invertebrates. They sometimes also feed on smaller salamanders, such as the red-backed salamander. The adult yellow-spotted salamander uses its sticky tongue to catch food. Defense. Salamanders have thin skins and soft bodies and move rather slowly, and at first sight, might appear to be vulnerable to opportunistic predation. However, they have several effective lines of defense. Mucus coating on damp skin makes them difficult to grasp, and the slimy coating may have an offensive taste or be toxic. When attacked by a predator, a salamander may position itself to make the main poison glands face the aggressor. Often, these are on the tail, which may be waggled or turned up and arched over the animal's back. The sacrifice of the tail may be a worthwhile strategy if the salamander escapes with its life, and the predator learns to avoid that species of salamander in the future. Can you eat salamanders? That depends on the species. Many salamanders are toxic, some dangerously so. There are stories of people eating them on dares and dying within hours. Some species are regularly eaten in parts of the world. Axolotls and their close relatives were historically on the menu for the indigenous people of Mexico, though now most species are endangered. Sure, you can eat anything. If you want to, you can even eat freshly laid cement. The real question is, should you? Salamanders are toxic and could very likely kill you by doing so. Conservation. A general decline in living amphibian species has been linked with an infectious disease that affects amphibians worldwide. Researchers also cite deforestation, resulting in fragmentation of suitable habitats, and climate change as possible contributory factors. Various conservation initiatives are being attempted around the world. The Chinese giant salamander, at 1.8 meters, the largest amphibian in the world, is critically endangered. As it is collected for food and for use in traditional Chinese medicine, an environmental education program is being undertaken to encourage sustainable management of wild populations. And captive breeding programs have been set up. The hellbender is another large, long-lived species with dwindling numbers and fewer juveniles reaching maturity than previously. Habitat loss, silting of streams, pollution, and disease have all been implicated in the decline. Of the 20 species of salamanders in Mexico, half are believed to have become extinct and most of the others are critically endangered. Specific reasons for the decline may include climate change, volcanic activity. But the main threat is habitat destruction, such as logging, agricultural activities, and human settlement. What's your opinion on researchers who hope to reverse engineer the remarkable regenerative processes for potential human medical applications? Hasta la vista, friends. Until then, peace, and have a wonderful day.